the book of Psalm 45, verse 2. And it said, thou art fairer than the children of men. Psalm 45, verse 2. Thou art fairer than the children of men. Grace is poured into your lips. God has blessed thee forever. Number one kind of grace is grace to be in the right place at the right time. It takes grace to be in the right place at the right time. And when you carry grace to be in the right place at the right time, you succeed in life. You excel in life. You progress in life. You bring forth on every side. The Bible says that they carried the lunch and they gave it to David. They asked him to go and give it to his brothers in the battlefield. He went there and he was in the right place at the right time. When Goliath came forth and started abusing the God of Israel, and David said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? He said, your head will be brought to my hand today. He was in the right place at the right time, because if they have not given him the lunch or the food to go and give to his brother, he will not be in the place where an enemy was mocking the children of God. He was in the right place at the right time. He was in the right place at the right time. I pray for you, you will carry grace to be in the right place at the right time. If you carry grace to be in the right place at the right time, you enter a place, you begin to solve problems. And you put them right and put them in place. Why? You carry grace to be in the right place at the right time. Number two kind of grace is grace to meet the right people. It takes grace to meet the right people. It takes grace to meet the right person in life. God will use a man to promote you. God will use a man to favor you. God will use a man to catapult you to the next level of your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. But you need grace to meet that man, to meet that woman. And I prophesy, I speak over your life. Right now, tomorrow, this week, this year, you will meet a man that will change your life. You will meet a man that will transform your life. You will meet a man that will push you to the next level of your life. In the bus, you will meet that man. In the plane, you will meet that man. In your neighborhood, you will meet that man. In the name of Jesus. Number three kind of grace you need. You need grace to do things right. You need grace. It takes grace to do things right. Some people do things and people don't like it. They try their best. People don't even appreciate them. Praise the name of the Lord. It takes grace to do things right. I pray for you from today, whatever you do, people will accept it in the name of Jesus. I tell people that grace will cover your errors and color your efforts. Grace will cover your errors and color your efforts. It takes grace to do things right. Grace will ignore your weakness and bring your greatness. That's what grace can do. It takes grace to do things right. From today, you begin to do things right. You begin to do things in a way that people will love. People will celebrate you in the office, will love you the way you do it, the way you talk, the way you pray, the way you preach, the way you dress. People will just accept you for who you are. Grace is the one speaking on your behalf. In the mighty name of Jesus, I speak over your life that we accept you. The Bible says he has made his grace abound to all. If grace can be extended to that your friend, it can be extended to you. Praise the name of the Lord. Number four kind of grace I want to introduce to you is grace to make money. Grace to make money. It takes grace to make money. Money is honey, but it takes grace to make money. It's not everybody that will be rich. It's if everybody is going to be rich, truck pusher will have been a billionaire. Praise God. But truck pusher, they will push and push. They will give them little change. They work more than some of us, but they collect less wages. Less salary or less appreciation. Praise the name of the Lord. I pray for you today. In the name of Jesus, receive grace to make money. Receive grace to be rich. Receive grace to be blessed. Receive grace to be better than your neighbors, better than your equals, better than your mates, in the name of Jesus. Five kind of grace I'm talking about, which is the last one, grace to survive every attack. It takes grace to survive attack. There are some people that have gone through what you went through, they died. But you went through it, you are still alive. It takes grace to survive. There are some people that have started a business, the business is no more. But you are still doing your own business. You are still surviving. There are some people that they pass through the road you pass through. They fail, they die, but you are still alive. You are still shining. You are still strong. You are a survivor because you carry grace to survive. It takes grace to survive. Bible says, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Every tongue that rises against us in judgment shall be condemned. When you carry the grace to survive attack, you won't die anyhow. You will survive it. You will go through it. He said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. God is with me for me to survive. To survive in the valley of the shadow of death. To survive in the valley of the shadow of sickness. To survive in the valley of the shadow of sorrow. I will pass through it. He said, though I go through the valley. I'm only going through not to stay, but to go through and come out of it. My going through cannot stop my breaking through. Because I carry grace to survive. Amen. I carry grace to survive. I will survive. I won't die in this place. I won't die in this problem. I won't die in this sickness. I won't die. I want you to believe it. You can't die in that sickness. You can't die in that sorrow. You can't die in that problem. You can't die as a poor man. You can't die jobless. You can't die being unemployed. You can't die as a single person. No, you are coming out. Because grace is coming upon you right now that will take you from where you are to the next level of your life. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Palace Fire Chapel presents Annual Convention 2015, themed Supernatural Grace, date Friday 31st July 10 p.m. to noon and Sunday 2nd August 9 a.m. prompt. Ministering Reverend Dr. Joshua Falabi.
I speak over your life. You may not have that certification or the document, but God will qualify you because of grace. Amen. God will raise you because of grace.
Amen. Ministering in Songs, Mike Abdul, Midnight Crew. Palace Treasure.
We send our sorrows into joy.
Others, don't miss it. This is your season.